you don't talk about your sex styles. Do you like doggy? Do you like touch your toe? Do you like fegede? I don't know what I'm saying, but I'm just like, for example, because my
see the glow, guys. The glow is epic. Guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Onozasi, and today I'm going to be taking you to one of the favorite spots to get swallow in Ekiti State. So if you are going to be coming here on tour or anything, you can come here. It's M&F Gilongwe, M&F. So it's going to be a tour, sha. Like, I'm going to be doing a series. I'll be taking you to different restaurants in Ekiti State. Send me money to come and support my ministry. Okay, so I'm going to be going there now. I'll get the food, then come home to come and chow, because I don't know how to eat outside, especially when it is swallow. So it's going to be fun. See ya. This place is not so far from my house, so it's trekkable. So there's no need to take bike or take cab or whatever. We're on our way. I'll soon be there. I'm saying we because my younger sister is with me, as usual, because she's going to be the one to record me. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I love you.
Now you are really getting YouTube. Better. I'm getting it at. Shout out to my YouTube mentor, Austin Betha. That guy has invested in my life. Okay, so let me zoom in so you can see the signpost from here. That is the signpost. My knee is shaking. Can you see now? Yeah, we're almost there. Here we are. So, and the pandemic is good. Okay, so let's go. We are here, guys. We are here. Yeah. So we couldn't get amala, but we got pounded yam. But this place, any kind of swallow is the best place for you. Okay, so we're going to eat our food. Instead of going home, we came to this area to come and take pictures. Can you see it? Okay, so we came here to come and take pictures. You know your girl is a picture freak, and it's not like we're using it to make money too. So it's not like we're just taking pictures for the world to see. So yeah, well, we're taking pictures for the world to see so that money can come in as a fashion blogger that I am. You can see this, my beautiful bag. Purse, actually, not a bag. So we came around to come take pictures, and now we're heading home. That's my partner in crime. This girl has like now a corner of this channel, because whatever you me more any month now you pass in here anyhow. So anyway, Sha, she's doing the work at the head. Look at the head. Okay, guys, see you guys at home. And we're going to be talking about, I don't know if I want to do this video while eating, it depends, but we're going to be gisting about Christian people that run away from talking about sex, like Kishele. Anyway, guys, see you. Bye.
Hey guys, so this is the following day. I could not vlog yesterday. There's so many conditions, the conditions of the egusi, condition of the foundation, condition of myself. So I decided that okay, because the gist itself is a very, you know, very serious gist. I want to ask our Christian aunties, our Christian uncles, our brothers and our sisters, why do you people to run away from sex talks when you are dating yourselves, even in marriage? I heard that a lot of Christian couples, that their marriage, maybe their sex life, there's no fire, there's no vibe. Why? When you are dating yourselves, apart from the fact that both of you will pray, both of you will gist, both of you will hang out, both of you will plan, you don't talk about your sex life. Like, you don't talk about your sex styles. Do you like doggy? Do you like touch your toe? Do you like fegede? I don't know what I'm saying, but I'm just like, for example, because I'm not from Marina, but listen, we need to know what we're doing. First and foremost, let me try to tell you that, see, this video is not for everybody. It's for those that want to learn things. Like, if you want to learn that, okay, you want to put ginger to your sex life. A lot of you are suffering, oh. Daddy wa and mommy wa. A lot of you are suffering. And that is why I am here to come and help you out. See, you cannot be dating somebody if both of you will not talk. See, sex is an integral part of a relationship. Why do we always lie like sex is not important? It's very important. Sex is an integral part of a relationship. You cannot be in a relationship with a guy. You cannot be in a relationship with a girl you want to get married to, that both of you are planning marriage. Because I know that, okay, let's assume now that in Christendom, because we know that some of us have received heartbreak in Christendom. But let us just say that in Christendom, you don't date for fun. Date with marriage in view, right? Mm-hmm. So now you date with marriage in view, and the both of you cannot talk about, okay, when we want to have sex, what turns you on, baby? Can I suck your can I suck your boobs? Can I? Why are you running away? I don't know. You would think in your mind, the old spirit will enter your marriage and say, touch here, move here. That's how both of you, all of you suffer. Talk about it. This is a sex therapist. If you have not done it before, go and meet a therapist. Let the therapist teach you. This is how you handle it. This is the way you can be satisfied. And that's how you're able to pray for your husband and for your wife. Because Listen, if the man is not satisfying you, you cannot pray. You cannot pray with joy in your heart. You cannot pray. A lot of you are hiding. You are hiding. You are hiding under your clothes. You know that you are struggling. I actually, sincerely, let's be serious now. I feel that it is very important for you to talk about sex. Sex is very important. Like, okay, guy, what are the dynamics for you? Lady, what are the dynamics for you? What do you want us to do? How do you want to be handled? There's some people that are not experimental. If you're very, very experimental with sex, you tell your spouse, before we get married, do I want to do that very experimental? We're going to try this. And you know, since it's a union, the both of you will be able to try different things. And if you're having difficulties with it, you visit a sex therapist that would, you know, help broaden your knowledge. Help the both of you to be able to understand this thing. And I don't know why, you know, a lot, sincerely, Christian couples run away from talking sex, intending couples especially, they run away from discussing sex, and it is very, very, it's not cool. I feel it's very important that we have these conversations, that, you know, you help yourself. There is no, maybe some of you think it's a sin. It is not a sin. I think some people think it's a sin. It's not a sin. It is knowing everything. You can't know about me if you don't know my sex life, if you don't know my finances, if you don't, everything works hand in hand. So it is important for you to discuss this with your partner. It is very important. Even during counseling sessions, I hear that they talk about these things a lot. So you too, talk about it. It is not bad. A lot of you are suffering. That's why I'm here to come and help you. Not good, brother. It's not good. Ask your spouse, what makes you horny? What would you like me to do differently? It is okay. After the both of you have finished praying, you talk about it. It's part. It's a part of life. Talking about it, yeah, doesn't mean that you want to indulge in it. In fact, talking about it will help you to build your mind against indulging in it anyhow. But hiding from it will push you into temptation. What did I say? Hiding and dodging will put you into temptation. But the both of you talk about it, the both of you, you know, dissect yourselves, the both of you will have it in mind that, oh, breast, when, for that time. Anyway, guys, if I've made sense to you, let me know in the comment section. Remember to follow me on all my social media platforms and subscribe to my channel if you haven't. My name is Onosa Sitel. I come here again.